This bittersweet heat is suffocating. I'm waiting and always hesitating. Kryptonite desires set my heart afire. Heart on fire. Set my heart afire.
Good morning, everyone. Pretender Not here with another electronics tutorial. I've just finished building my trailer light tester for testing the lights on your trailer and for testing the trailer plug on your vehicle. The first part of this video I'll be explaining the concept of how it works and what components and modules and cables you will need and materials. I will also on the next part show you my Mark 1 version of this. This is Mark 2. This is one I'm going to draw schematics for and have everything at the end of the video. All items will be in the description, and if you would like to follow me on Maker, where I have also got electronics tutorials listed, feel free to. Onto the concept. This tester is for testing your lights on your trailer, for testing a plug in your car. I've made it so that it works in three ways. The first way it works is you plug it into the back of your car. Your vehicle will then self-powerless machine. You don't have to worry about any power supplies. You test your brakes, your lights, your indicators. These will flash if your plug's wired correctly. The second way is for testing your trailer itself. To test your trailer itself, you put the male end of your trailer into the female end of the cable. You will switch this on, and this is powered by an 18650 battery with a TP4056 battery charger. You test your ABS, your electric brakes if you have electric brakes, your side lights and your indicators. That was the second way it operates. The third way it operates is, let's say you forgot to charge your 18650 battery. I have included a 2.1x5.5 power jack in here which bypasses the button. So you will get your battery with crockery clips. You will get your 2.1x5.5 power jack, plug it in, it will power the unit, and you can use it as normal. Another way you can use it is by getting a 240 volt AC to 12 volt DC power supply with a 2.1x5.5 power jack. These are common. 2.1x5.5 is a common 12 volt power jack. These are usually used for devices such as your BT hub, your small power consuming devices. On the components list, I explain about your TP4056 battery charger and about the two LEDs and about desoldering them from the board. If you follow and do it the way I have built it, you will not have to actually do that at all. When splicing your two plugs into your cable, on your male end, which goes into your vehicle, put rectifier diodes on each splice. That will stop any electricity flowing from this box back to your vehicle. Now, if it does happen, it shouldn't be a problem. Prevention's better than a cure. Let's just move on now and we'll get your components and we'll have everything listed at the bottom. This is Big Daddy. Big Daddy was good to me for a long time, always worked, but I just want to change it. I just had momentary switches. We had LEDs, we had an on-off switch, we had a power jack, we had a male and female 8-pin connector, we had a 240 volt AC to 12 volt DC converter, and we had a cutlery tips for our box. But let's go ahead and see what we need to build this project. We need one ABS project box. This one is 100mm by 150mm by 50mm. We will need one epoxy double-sided prototyping PCB board. This is 80mm by 120mm. This will fit inside your project box without any problems. You will need six momentary SPST single pole single throw switches. You'll need one rocker switch, single pole single throw again. You will need some Molex PCB connectors. You may choose not to use these. I don't even know if I will. It's up entirely up to yourself. You will need 10 LEDs. I've two amber for my indicators. I've some reds for my brakes and sides, and some blues. You will also need the holders that come along with them. This here I bought as 12 volt LEDs, which there's no such thing. These are 3 volt LEDs with a 12 volt built-in resistor on the leg. If you want to buy these, they are handy because they're already tailed. But if you choose to go along with just 3 volt LEDs because you have them, you will need to order these 470 ohm LED resistors, or they can be sold as 12 volt to 3 volt LED resistors. You may need to order some of those. You will need to order one N401 rectifier diodes. You will need to get one 18650 battery holder. You will need to get one 18650 battery, which I salvaged from a laptop, but you can buy them on eBay. You will need these come in a pair. These are 8-pin connectors. I had to order this from eBay from China because there was none on the Irish market or the UK market. So if you're wanting to copy this project, go ahead and order those now. You will need one 2.1 by 5.5 power jack. Now on to our modules. The modules we are using is, the first one is a NE555. NE555 is actually the model of the chip. It's a timer chip. But it's a NE55 pulse cycle duty generator. What that does is, you have a volt in, you have your ground, you have your volt out. The volt out goes to an LED. They have two potentiometers. On these potentiometers you can change it, so the frequency and the timing of the flash of the LED. So if you mess about with these, you will get the frequency and the timing. If you look at your indicator in your car, you can mess about with it till you're in sync. You only need to add this to this circuit if you want your indicators on your trailer to flash whenever you push a button. If you're happy with a solid yellow light, amber light, you don't need to order this, but sure, it does no harm ordering it. This next fantastic little module is a buck converter. It converts from 3.3 or 3.7 or 5 or 12 volts, or 6 volts to 12 volt DC, and it regulates them. So you have your little pins here. You have your voltage VO, voltage in, your ground, your second ground for your voltage out, and that will convert your 18650 battery, which is 3.7, and it will regulate it at a 12 volt for your trailer LEDs. You will need your TP4056. This is a fantastic little protected module for charging your 18650 battery. It's got a micro USB for charging from any micro USB phone charger. which it has is over protection, so it won't overcharge the battery, and it's got under protection, so it won't let the battery undercharge. As you can see here, this is a little computer power supply I made into a battery charger. On here you can see 4 TP4056 modules. I have a 5-volt feed coming out of my computer charger. You can see that two of them are blue. That means these two batteries are charged. That's their state, that's blue. These other two are red, they're in a state of still charging. So on here, you can see two LEDs. This one's red, and this one's blue. You have to desolder these off the board and add cables to them to put them into the side of your project box. I think that's pretty much the basics of what we need to build this system. Anything else I'll explain when we go along. I have drew up very rough schematics here. These rough schematics will work. It's got the rectifier diodes, LEDs, resistors, and the modules all on it. Whenever I do build this, I'm going to draw a confirmed schematic so that anybody can copy this. This circuit is not copied from anything for starters, because there's nothing else like this out there, and it's definitely not freeware. So this is my own design. Anybody can copy it, modify it, change it. It's entirely up to yourselves. But it's not copyrighted, and I'm making it free for anyone who would like to build it. Let's move on to the build mode.
did.